The road to renaming Veterans Memorial Drive begins with the tireless work of some dedicated group of members of our community and the North Shore School District, who worked together to create the memorial honoring North Shore students who gave their lives in the service of our country. North Shore Veterans Memorial, which is behind us, is located at the Pop Canning Field where we are and was dedicated in 2019. And for all of you that weren't there, it was a very nice ceremony. The memorial honors the men and women from the North Shore School District who have served honorably and courageously to protect our freedoms and liberties while serving in the Armed Forces of the United States. They gave the ultimate sacrifice and they will never be forgotten. They asked for a moment of silence, but I wanted to kind of read something else instead. I noticed that a number of the veterans are wearing poppies. There's an old poem called In Flanders Fields that was written at the end of the First World War, the war to end all wars. That would have been nice. It says, in Flanders Fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row. That marks our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, we felt dawn, we saw the sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from fallen hands we throw, the torch be yours and hold it high, if you break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders Fields. That was written by a Canadian surgeon that had just lost one of his best friends. And there wasn't anyone to do anything at the service. So he wrote this, and it became fairly memorable shortly after the war. And to this day, veterans will wear poppies in honor of all the veterans that are not here with us anymore. To honor the veterans, you guys about ready to open this one up a little bit? In honor to the veterans of our community, to commemorate Veterans Day, the city of Bothell has designated a portion of 188th between 92nd and Bothell Way as Veterans Memorial Drive. Directional signs leading to the North Shore Veterans Memorial have also been installed to encourage visitors to come and visit that memorial site. I'd like to introduce a couple of gentlemen that were very instrumental in all of this. And that's Parle Guthrie and Jim Morrison from the local VFW. Would you come up and say a few words, sir?
First of all, I'd like to say happy birthday to the United States Marine Corps. Today is their 246th birthday, and I'm very proud to say that I'm one of them. My name is Parle Guthrie. Jim Morrison and I both graduated from Bothell High School in 1964. Within a couple of weeks of graduating, I was headed to MCRD in California, Marine Corps Recruit Depot. And then Vietnam as soon as my boot camp training was over. I think I was probably one of the first ones in my class to get to Vietnam. We were told that the Marine unit that was going, we were the first Marine unit that was going to land in July. As you can see on the memorial, two of our 1964 classmates and friends died in Vietnam. After hearing about their deaths, I wanted to honor them in some way, as well as the others who died in other wars. But it wasn't until after our Bothell High School 50-year reunion that I decided to do something. Getting together with my old classmates spurred me to find a way to honor our fallen classmates. They needed to have a place of recognition where we could honor them for their ultimate sacrifice. When I first started working on the project, it was before Dr. Reed became the new district superintendent. At that time, I didn't realize what a huge undertaking it was going to be. But I quickly found out that I was going to need help. So about the same time Dr. Reed was sworn in, I asked my classmate Jim Morrison for that help, and he gladly gave it to me. Together, Jim and I spearheaded an effort to get a granite memorial in the exact location it is today, because there just wasn't any other location that was appropriate. So with the cooperation of Dr. Reed, her staff, and 2 years of committee meetings, we came up with what is now probably the nicest granite memorial in the Puget Sound area. When Jim recently came up with the idea of renaming the street, I was excited. It would be a perfect way to show that the entire community was thankful for our local veterans who had lost their lives. So Jim and I would like to thank the city of Bothell in general, the city council, especially Councilman Tom Agnew, because he's a veteran himself, the Public Works Department, and anyone else that was involved in helping us with this project. By adding the name Veterans Memorial Drive to the street that parallels the memorial, it says that we will never forget the sacrifices that were made for our country. May God bless our fallen classmates. Thank you.
It has been said that a veteran, whether active duty, discharged, retired, or reserve, drafted or volunteer, is someone who at one time in his or her life wrote a blank check payable to the United States of America for an amount up to and including their life. Fortunately, most of us who have served never have to make that sacrifice. But the North Shore veterans, students named on the North Shore Veterans Memorial did. There are 17 names engraved on the memorial, all students who attended or graduated from North Shore School District, from World War II to the recent conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan, who lost their lives fighting for our country or carrying out their assigned duties in peacetime. As we researched the names to include in the memorial, one thing became very apparent. These men were achievers, and they were heroes. Please let me share the stories of just five. Navy Lieutenant Patrick S. Myrick, Inglemore High School class of 1991, went to the University of Washington and received his bachelor's degree in aeronautical and astronautical engineering, then became a Navy pilot to fulfill his dream to fly. Air Force Captain Ross A. LaTorre, Bothell High School class of 1976, was a graduate of the United States Air Force Academy and a fighter pilot and training officer. Army Chief Warrant Officer Richard C. Worthington Jr., Bothell High School class of 1964, felt an obligation to serve. He dropped out of his studies at Washington State University, joined the Army, and completed flight school to become a helicopter pilot. He completed one tour successfully in Vietnam and transferred to Berlin, Germany, when that sense of obligation struck him again. He volunteered for a second tour in Vietnam and was killed in a mid-air collision with another helicopter. His body has never been recovered. Army First Lieutenant Charles R. Slusser, also Bothell High School class of 1964, felt that same sense of duty and joined the Army. After basic and advanced training, he was chosen to attend Officer Candidate School. Upon successful completion of Infantry OCS, he went to Jump School, finishing first in his class and named Distinguished Leadership Graduate. From there, he went to Special Forces and Jungle Warfare Training in Panama to become Ranger Qualified and the Green Beret before going to Vietnam. After completing his time in the field, he was offered a desk job in relative safety, but he refused and chose instead to stay in the field. Marine Staff Sergeant Daryl Eugene Ayers graduated from Bothell High School in 1957 and almost immediately joined the Marine Corps and decided to make it his career. In Vietnam, at age 32, he was quite a bit older than the other troops, who fondly called him Pappy.
As a reconnaissance squad leader, he took his job seriously and took good care of his men. On 19 March 1970, the seven-man long-range reconnaissance patrol he was leading suddenly came under a heavy volume of automatic weapons fire from enemy soldiers concealed nearby. Staff Sergeant Ayers intentionally and immediately placed himself in front of his comrade to protect him from the fusillade of automatic fire. He was posthumously awarded the Navy Cross, our nation's second highest award for heroism, by President George Bush on 2 April 2008. An entire chapter is devoted to the actions of Staff Sergeant Ayers in the book First Forest Recon Company, Sunrise at Midnight by Bill Peters, and his heroism is featured in Etched in Stone by Betty Lou Gang. Like Rich Worthington, Darrell Ayers' body has never been recovered. Can you imagine the potential lives these men could have lived given the opportunity? The remaining 12 names have equally compelling stories. All were truly heroes that we, as a community, can be very proud of and very proud to honor. When Parle and I envisioned the creation of the North Shore Veterans Memorial, we had three goals. To honor all North Shore School District students, faculty, or staff who lost their life in an armed conflict or while performing their assigned duties as a member of the Armed Forces of the United States. Secondly, to provide a place for the families and community to honor their fallen, and in the case of the families of Rich Worthington and Darrell Ayers, to find some kind of closure and welcome them home. Thirdly, to teach current and future North Shore School District students the duty and sacrifice made by their fellow students. Renaming Northeast 188th Street between Bothell Way Northeast and 92nd Avenue Northeast, Veterans Memorial Drive, along with the new signs pointing the way to the memorial, will help draw more attention to the North Shore Veterans Memorial and help us to further meet our goals. But it also expands the reach of that, and Veterans Memorial Highway honors all veterans, even more than those just named on the memorial. When you honor our fallen, you honor all veterans, and we thank the City of Bothell, the Bothell City Council, and the entire Bothell community. Our classmates may be gone, but they will never be forgotten. Thank you.